Illinois Congressman Adam Kinzinger. Now, Kinzinger is a pilot in the Air National Guard, previously served in Iraq and Afghanistan. He's also a Republican who has said he doesn't think he can support Donald Trump for president. Congressman, thanks for joining me, as always.
You bet, Jake. Thanks.
So, first of all, let's get your response to Trump's foreign policy speech today. He said that we can find common ground with Russia in the fight against ISIS. He said, if you work with us against terrorism, you're an ally. Do you agree?
No. I mean, look, let's think about what the Russians are doing. First off, the Russians are aligned with two very bad people, Bashar al-Assad in Syria and the Iranians. They're all kind of one alliance right now aimed at propping up this guy that's murdered 500,000 people. You know, American standards, I think, should shun that, just to say the least. The other thing is the Russians are constantly engaged in bombing medical facilities in Syria. There's a human tragedy in Aleppo right now that the Russians have been bombing indiscriminately civilians and, frankly, allies of the United States and the West. So this idea that somehow allying ourselves with Russia and saying that we're going to ally ourselves with anybody. ISIS is a very important foreign policy problem right now, probably the most important we're facing, but it's not the only important foreign policy problem. You have the Russians, frankly, you know, annexing Crimea, parts of Georgia, and you see what looks like to be a military buildup for potentially an impetus for a larger invasion of Ukraine, not to mention their current Spetsnaz in eastern Ukraine.
One of the bigger applause lines during Mr. Trump's speech was when he pledged an end to nation building. Now, that probably polls well. What do you think of it as a matter of policy?
Yeah, that's it. It polls well. You know, I think basically through the last 30, 40 years of American politics, people talk about the end of nation building. But on the one hand, you can't say we shouldn't have left Iraq because, frankly, we were nation building in Iraq, and that it was us leaving that nation building mission that led to this rise of ISIS, which I actually agree with, that it led, you know, an area for ISIS to operate, expand out of Syria. But nation building is not something that anybody's advocating. The U.S. should just go into all these nations and rebuild them on our own. But, you know, bringing allies together in the Middle East, for instance, the Saudis, the Jordanians, to help to create a post-ISIS government, a post-Assad government, to build a government in Libya. You can't solve. Otherwise, what you're going to end up doing is it's basically like dropping a rock in a bathtub. For a moment, you're going to vacate an area of ISIS or of water, but it's simply going to be refilled by ISIS II, Al-Qaeda III, or whatever the next iteration is. So we don't want the United States to be the sole nation builders. Nobody's advocating for that. But this idea that helping to build post-terrorist governments is wrong, I think, is frankly pretty bad policy.
Any thoughts on the charges against Paul Manafort and his response today about his ties, allegedly, to the pro-Russian Ukrainian party, the former Ukrainian party that ran the country?
Yeah, look, I think Donald Trump ought to really investigate this and where his chief advisor, what his association with the Russians are. Look, very well may be that within this corruption, you know, they forged Paul Manafort's names as a way to make these payouts. So I'm not going to level that charge. But we do know that there was a push for some reason at the RNC to take offensive weapons out of our platform. You know, that wasn't anything anybody was talking about. It just happened. You know, there's been this affection in the campaign for Russia and Vladimir Putin. So in my thought, I have concerns for the chief advisor of Donald Trump, you know, having done work for a pro-Russian government in Ukraine, and then all of a sudden there's this real affection for Russia in the campaign. It very much violates what I believe is a Republican, which is we have to be an example of people to people that live behind iron curtains and under oppressive regimes of how to live life better.
Congressman, it's not as though Illinois is a particularly contested state, but how do you think you're going to vote in November for president?
You know, I still have to go through that decision. I've never said I'm a never Trump guy. I'm saying I'm having a hard time seeing how I get there. I definitely will never vote for Hillary Clinton. So that's something I continue to go through, and I've made my thoughts of that clear, and we've got 90 days.
All right. Congressman Kinzinger, thank you so much. Appreciate it.
You bet, Jake. Take care.